Hey everybody, dutchsinse here. It is 1:15 a.m. Central Time on Wednesday, April 16th, 2014. And we're looking at Earthquake 3D here, and I've got the earthquakes turned down just for the last 48 hours. I'm showing you the earthquake swarm that's been occurring here just west of Yellowstone at the western portion of the Yellowstone magma chamber. And this is something that I've been reporting on now for the last several weeks. Now, I've got breaking news on the area, specifically on this spot here where we've been seeing multiple earthquakes occur over the last month, and it's been a legitimate swarm that you can see here, and this of course is the Oklahoma fracking swarm. But here, western edge of the Yellowstone magma chamber, if you've been paying attention to my posts, I've been showing you guys, here's the earthquake area, here's the magma chamber. They've identified that the magma chamber extends that far over into Idaho, and then the rise of the area confirmed. 2-inch rise since New Year's and pushed a half inch southeast. So we're talking about this area here raised 2 inches and pushed a half inch down to the southeast, and it's been causing earthquakes now, pushed along the edge of the craton down here to the south. Now this story today says that the USGS is aware of the hundreds of earthquakes, and today they are installing special seismometers in the region to monitor the activity. And the professional down here at the bottom, the disaster preparedness expert for the region, is telling everybody to possibly prepare, that it's a good idea to have bottled water and canned goods on hand just in case a big shaker should strike. And again, the threat in the area is not for an eruption. We've shown this, and I've shown this in my post, there's no question about it, that the threat lies for an earthquake. Like the 1950s 7.0, 7.9, caused major damage in the region. We're looking at an earthquake threat in the region. So it's not good to downplay the threat at Yellowstone. It is good to downplay the threat of an eruption at Yellowstone right now. However, the earthquake threat is growing and building. They are making note of it. That is in this story here today. They wouldn't be installing special seismometers in the region unless something was really going on. So that leads me to say, have an earthquake plan, be ready, be prepared, along the edge of the North American craton. There's somebody that came over to my page and said, oh, the craton edge is not being displaced, that it goes thousands of miles over to the sea. No, we're talking about the unsubducted portion. Again, this is the part that has remained relatively stable and untouched over hundreds of millions of years. Compare the edge here to the earthquakes here. Follow the edge. The edge is being displaced. Now this, again, turns modern geology on its head. Go read the article. They're puzzled. First paragraph, they're puzzled as to what. No, you shouldn't be puzzled. I've explained it now multiple times. I understand it turns everything you know on your head, but there it is. The earthquakes are progressing from west to east across the edge of the North American craton. Whether you want to believe it or not, it doesn't matter. It's proved. There it is. We can watch them pop off. Again, you can just watch them over the days as they progress from west to east. It's there right before your eyes. People who don't want to see it are obviously just parrots from school who don't want to learn something new, maybe. Maybe they don't want to bother learning some kind of new science. I don't know what the explanation is for why people wouldn't want to acknowledge that this is occurring when you can see it right in front of your eyes. They're installing special seismometers in the region, and they're recommending that people prepare. I'm telling you guys the same thing, have been for several weeks now. Have a plan, be ready, be prepared, just in case. You may never have to use it. You better hope you never have to use it. Intermountain West, large earthquake, we're talking about landslides, we're talking about a lot of houses with stone frontage to the houses. I lived in Colorado myself. If a 7.9 strikes up in Yellowstone, or just north in Montana, you're talking about the entire mountain range there having some serious problems. All the houses built on those steep slopes in Denver, for instance, you would be feeling that rumbling, that shaking coming from Yellowstone if a 7.9, like the 1950s, if that happened again. Okay, guys, hang in there. Much love. Just wanted to show you someone else finally noticed, and they're warning people. The professionals are warning people, not just me now. You don't just have to take my word for it. Now, let's hope nothing happens, right? I mean, that's the best case scenario. Things calm down You can see where the pressure is coming from. It's coming from the West Pacific. Again, geologists saying that earthquakes don't transfer. Well, we saw two back-to-back across the Pacific Ocean, 8.0 earthquakes and 7.0 earthquakes in the last few weeks. I'd say that there is a pressure transfer that's occurring. Again, whether or not they want to admit it, who cares? You can see it right in front of your own eyes. Okay? Cheers, guys. Hang in there. Much love.